Very good morning class. Today we are going to start with the exercise 8.1 of chapter quadrilateral. First question, very simple one. In this question we are given that the ratio of the angles of the quadrilateral are 3:5:9:13. It is given that ratio of angles in a quadrilateral, this is given to you, that is 3:5:9:13. We need to calculate the measure of these angles. So we need to calculate the measure of these angles. So we will let the angles be 3x in terms of the ratio, 3x, 5x, 9x and 13x. Now the sum of the angles is equal to 360 by angle sum property, by angle sum property of quadrilateral, angle sum property of quadrilateral, we know that angle sum property of quadrilateral, we know that the sum of the angles of the quadrilateral is equal to 360 degree. So that means 3x plus of 5x plus of 9x plus of 13x equals to 360. So 5 plus 3 is 8, 8 plus 9 is 17, 17 plus 13 is 30. So we got 30x equals to 360. So x equals 360 upon 30. The value of x is 12. Now we can calculate the measure of each angle. 3x will be 3 times of 12, that is equal to 36 degree, and 5x will be 5 times of 12, that is equal to 60, 9x equals to 9 times of 12, that is 108, and 13x equals to 13 times of 12, that is 156 degree. You can also check by adding all these four angles. If the sum of these four angles is coming 360, that means your multiplication is correct. So the measure of the four angles are 36 degree, 60 degree, 108 degree and 156 degree. Question is, if diagonals of a parallelogram are equal, then show that it is a rectangle. So we need to prove that it is a rectangle. So for that, first of all, we need to draw a rectangle itself. Okay, because we need to prove that the given parallelogram is a rectangle. Okay, so we will be drawing first of all figure, that is figure of a rectangle. So here ABCD is a rectangle. And in this rectangle, the diagonals, it is given that ABCD is a parallelogram. So given that ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. And the diagonals are equal. Diagonals, that means diagonal AC and BD, they are equal. Okay. So these diagonal AC and BD are equal. AC is equal to BD. Okay. we need to prove that ABCD is a rectangle. ABCD is a rectangle. So as we have studied that in order to prove that a parallelogram is a rectangle, we need to prove that one of the angle is 90 degrees. So for that we will be taking two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle ABC this triangle and BAD this triangle. These two triangles we will be taking, okay? And after that we will prove the congruency of these two triangles. So in triangle ABC and BAD, AB and BA is equal because it is the common side, okay, and BC and AD will be equal, opposite sides of parallelogram. It is given the question that ABCD is a parallelogram, so opposite side of the parallelogram are equal, as well as AC equals to BD, that is the diagonals of the given parallelogram are equal. It is given in the question. AC is equal to BD is given in the question. So by SSS congruence, we have proved that triangle ABC is congruent with triangle BAD. And if ABC and BAD are congruent, then we can also say that by SSS congruence, okay, so then we can see that the angle ABC will be equal to angle BAD by CPCT. So if ABC and BAD are equal, and ABC and BAD are the two adjacent angles of the parallelogram, and we know that since ABCD is a parallelogram, so AD and BC will be parallel, so angle ABC and angle BAD will be the consecutive interior angles, because the adjacent angles of a parallelogram, suppose this is a parallelogram, so the two angles of a parallelogram, any two angles of a parallelogram will always be consecutive interior angles and the sum will be 180 degrees. So we can write angle ABC plus of angle BAD equals 180, because they are the co-interior angles. So we can say from equation 1 and 2, we can substitute the value of angle BAD from equation number 1 as angle ABC. In place of BAD, we will substitute as angle ABC. So we can write it as angle ABC plus of angle ABC equals to 180. So we can say 2 times of angle ABC equals to 180. So angle ABC is equal to 180 upon 2, that is 90 degrees. So we can say that ABCD is a parallelogram in which one angle is 90 degrees, therefore ABCD is a parallelogram. Sorry, is a rectangle, because we know that a parallelogram in which one angle is 90
is a rectangle. Okay, so therefore we say that ABCD is a parallelogram in which one angle is 90 degree. Therefore, the parallelogram ABCD is a rectangle. Hope you have understood the question. Question number 3. Show that if the diagonals of quadrilateral bisect each other at right angle, then it is a rhombus. So first of all, since we have to prove that it is a rhombus, we have to draw the figure of a rhombus. So we have drawn the figure. Now we will start with what is given. It is given that ABCD is a quadrilateral. ABCD is a quadrilateral, and the diagonals AC and BD of the quadrilateral ABCD, AC and BD, bisect at 90 degree. And if AC and BD bisect at 90 degree, that means each of the angles, angle A, suppose this is O, angle AOB is equal to angle BOC. Therefore, angle AOB is equal to angle BOC is equal to angle AOD is equal to angle COD equals to 90 degree. Each of the angle is 90 degree, as well as AO and OC, BO and OD are equal. AO will be equal to OC and BO will be equal to OD. Okay, hope it is clear. Now we need to prove that ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, so in order to prove that it is a rhombus, we have to take, we will take the triangles, any two adjacent triangles. Suppose if we have taken in triangle AOB and triangle AOD, AOB and AOD we have taken. So AOB and AOD, we know that OB is equal to OD, OB and OD are equal. It is given that diagonal bisect each other, so we can write given, because above we have already written all these things. So it is given the question that OB and OD are equal. Now angle AOB is equal to angle AOD, because each 90 degree given in the question. And third thing is that AO and AO is the common side. So we have proved that by SSS congruence, we have proved that triangle AOB is congruent with triangle AOD. Congruency is proved. So like we have proved the congruency of these two triangles, similarly we can prove the congruency of these two triangles by SSS. Since AO and OC is equal, OD and OD are common, and AOD and COD will be each 90 degree. So these two triangles are also congruent. So we can write similarly, triangle AOD is congruent with triangle COD. And here if triangle AOB is congruent with triangle AOD, then what we can say? We can say that the side AB is equal to the side AD by CPCT. And similarly, if AOD is congruent with COD, so we can say that AD is equal to CD by CPCT. Similarly, the triangle
COD and triangle BOC will also be congruent, because CO and CO is the common side, BO and OD are equal, because it is given that the diagonal bisect each other, diagonal AC bisect BD into equal halves, as well as angle BOC and angle COD is equal because both are 90 degree. So we can say that triangle COD is congruent with triangle BOC. So we can say that CD is also equal to BC by CPCT. So from these equations, for example, if I take it as equation number 1, 2 and 3, so from equation 1, 2 and 3, we can say that AB is equal to AD is equal to CD is equal to BC. Means all the four sides of the given quadrilateral are equal, and if all the four sides of a quadrilateral are equal, therefore a quadrilateral in which all the four sides are equal is a rhombus. So we say that ABCD is a rhombus. Okay, you can also write if you want that a quadrilateral in which all the sides are equal is a rhombus. Okay, question number 4, show that diagonals of a square are equal and they bisect each other at right angle. So first of all, we have to draw the figure of a square, because it is given already that the given square is given. So it is given that ABCD is a square. Okay, we need to prove that first part AC is equal to BD. That means the diagonals AC and BD are equal. The diagonals AC and BD are equal. First part. Second thing we have to prove that and bisect each other at right angle. That is AC and BD bisect each other at 90 degree. Okay, this is what we need to prove in the question. So we start with our proof. So for proving that the diagonals are equal, in a similar manner as we have proved in the previous question, we will take triangle BAD and ABC. ABC and BAD, and BA is equal to AB, that is the common side. Angle BAD is equal to angle ABC, because it is the angle of the square each 90 degree, angle of square ke sare angles, all angles of square are 90 degree. So angle BAD and angle ABC is equal. And the third thing is that AD is equal to BC. Sides of a square. Okay, so by side angle side congruence, we have proved that triangle BAD is congruent with triangle ABC by SAS congruence. And if it is so, then we can say that BD is equal to AC by CPCT. So we have proved the first part. Now in the second part, we have to prove that AC and BD bisect at 90 degree. For that, we have to take the triangles in triangle AOB and COD. If this is O, then AOB and triangle COD means the two adjacent angles, and in the two adjacent angles we know that already AOB and COD, we can see that angle OAB and angle OCD . So here we are taking the two triangles AOB, this one, not adjacent angles, with triangles, basically we are taking two opposite triangles. If we are taking two opposite triangles, then in the two triangles, angle OAB, because they are the parallel sides, they are the parallel side, opposite sides of a square are parallel as well as equal. So the angle made by this side with the transversal or with the diagonal AC, that means this angle and this angle will be equal. So we can say that in triangle AOB and COD, we can say that angle OAB and angle OCD are equal. The reason is alternate, they are alternate interior angles. Okay. They are alternate interior angles. As you can see that AB and CD are parallel lines and AC is a transversal. So the alternate interior angles OAB and OCD will be equal. So that is what I have written, angle OAB is equal to angle OCD. And after that, AB and CD will be equal because they are the sides of the triangle, sides of square. And after that, we can also say that these two angles, that is, if we are considering CD and AB as the two sides, parallel sides, and BD as the transversal, then these angles will also be equal by, because angle ODC and angle OBA, they will be also alternate interior angles. So we can write angle OBA is equal to angle ODC. OBA equals to angle ODC, again by alternate interior angles. So by angle side angle congruence, we have proved that triangle AOB is congruent with triangle COD by ASA congruence. Okay. So these two triangles are congruent. Now if this is so, then we can say that OB is equal to OD and AO is equal to CO. So OB is equal to OD, and AO is equal to CO, means the diagonals are bisecting each other. So hence it is proved, therefore diagonals AC and BD bisect each other. But we have to prove that they are bisecting at 90 degree. So for that we have to prove that angle AOB is 90. So for that again we have to take two triangles, that is triangle AOB and AOD, adjacent triangle, in triangle AOB and triangle AOD. Now we have already proved that OB and OD are equal, so we can say OB is equal to OD, proved above. here in these two triangles, OB is equal to OD is already proved, and OA is equal to OA, common side, AB is equal to AD, that is the sides of the square. So we can say OB is equal to OD already proved, OA is equal to OA, that is the common side, and AB is equal to AD, sides of a square. So by SSS congruence, we can say that triangle AOB is congruent with triangle AOD. And if this is so, then we can say angle AOB is equal to angle AOD. Angle AOB, this angle, and angle AOD, these two angles are equal. And if they are equal, as well as, since BD is a straight line, BD is a straight line, so AOB and AOD are the linear pair of angles. AOB and AOD are the linear pair of angles. So we can write angle AOB plus of angle AOD is equal to 180 degree, because they are linear pair. This is by CPCT, linear pair of angles. So from equation 1 and 2, if we substitute the value of angle AOD as angle AOB, so we have got AOB plus of angle AOB equals to 180. So 2 times of angle AOB equals to 180. That is angle AOB, which implies that angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. That means this thing is also proved, that the diagonals of the given square bisect at 90 degree. So therefore we can say that AC and BD bisect each other at 90 degree. So all the three things is proved, that is the diagonals are equal, AC is equal to BD, the diagonals bisect each other, as well as the diagonal bisect each other at 90 degree. Hope you have understood the question. Thank you, class. That's it for today.